Okay, let's go. Where are we? We got Hall and Woodhouse, we got a badger. Now, I'm not sure if I've done this before, and they've changed names around. I think they've got a few that they've changed names on, and it's a bit slippery, I don't know. Maybe it's okay, but people are going to be buying, oh, we've got to try that one, we've not had it yet, and you know, first gold's been changed to first something, first come, first serve, or whatever. And I think we might have had this one, but this is a firkin fox. You got to get your pronunciation right with these, some of these beers. It's a firkin fox, so it's a firkin, hopefully it's a firkin good one. Firkins basically, you know, where you got kilderkins, firkins, and all sorts of different sizes of barrels and kegs and whatever, you know. I can't remember how many pints in a firkin. Is it 144? Is it? No, 70. 72, is it a firkin? I think kilderkin's the most. Oh, do you know what? I can't even remember anymore. Right, so let's crash it up. I used to know all these once, and my brain kind of drifts and flies away. Now, one thing to remember about these guys, they're established back in one of the oldest brewers in the land, and they're established way back in 1777. And one thing you've got to remember about these is that a lot of their beers have got a quintessentially British taste, similar to things like Shepherd Neame's and things like that. You're not often talking about American IPA, and big woo fruits and all that business. So, I mean, it says citrus hopped. They will mean like a Cascade or something, you know. Sure, it says on it. Cascade, Celia and Cascade. Ooh, that kind of sounds nice. But, you know, you're kind of talking a little bit more subtly done than that. There's the crown, by the way, in Dorset. Down in Dorset. Where, you don't have a cold in Dorset. You have a Dorset. You have a code. I've got a code. Sorry. It's 4.6 on the Abv. I'm sure that used to be bigger as well. But, look, if it is a different beer, we're going to be kind of re-reviewing it. Is there such a word? Well, how would you re-review a beer? Is there such a word as re-review it? Is it hyphenated if it is? Would it be re-review? Sorry. Well, look, 1993. Way back to the old beer festivals in that 1993. Right. So, here he is. Let's pour it in there and see what we got. So let's give it a go, the old badgers. Pouring him gently. And then at the end, raise the bottle a little bit. And there you go. And then you figure out how much head you want in there. One thing I don't like here already is, if I can put the bottle down here. Up there we go. One thing I don't like already is them big kaplunky bubbles. Wee, getting going up there. Kind of false carbonated and very, very burpy that will be. So straight away I'm not enjoying the look of it. What are we talking? Have we got a bit of plain paper anywhere? Can't find a bit of plain paper. Oh, it's a bit behind me. Oh, God. It's in the glass. Never mind. I've got it in the glass with a few bits chucked in there and pens and whatever else. Look, that's what it is through the thing there. Golden is what it is. Just dark golden, kind of bronzy golden. Right, let's have a twirl and a sniff. Twirl it, sniff. It smells nice. You've got nice little, when it says citrus, I think this is more like a jam citrus, like a warm jam, kind of when you walk into Granny's, you know, Granny's kitchen there, and she's got jam on the old cooker, and not jam, marmalade on the cooker and that, and she's making up some marmalade. That kind of warm sort of mulled wine almost, them warm citrus notes. Lovely old earthy hops sort of smells in there as well. I don't think it's just down to them two hops. I think they've got bittering hops in there as well. And it does smell a slight over attenuated grain in that, or over kind of, not attenuated, over supped grain in that. It's like overspent. Is that peanut husk sort of background? Almost a putty note somewhere in the background. It's like they've drained the grain galore. And you've got an overworked grain a little bit in there. But that is not always a bad thing. You know, it can be a bit nutty as well. But it smells nice. It smells very gentle and nice and sexy. So let's give it a go. Cheers. Carbonation is much more gentle on the tongue. This is what I call a good garden beer. It's not one of those that are gonna, you know, kind of have you, ooh, what the, ooh, and all this business, and trying to figure out all the different intricacies of the beer, and all the flavour and the taste notes and the mix and the combination. It's kind of a bit more subtle, not even subtle, I don't, that's the wrong word, it's a bit more just, it is, you know, it's kind of, it is a beer, and it is got, it's got certain, it has, I should say, it has got certain flavours that are gentle citrus notes. What's it say about citrus? It's just citrus hopped. So it doesn't say like massive citrus and all that. So citrus hopped is about right. It's got like little cascade notes in it. If you ever look in to see what cascade is like, that's cascade. You can taste the cascade in there. That cascade sort of warm marmalade sort of thing going on. Oh. I kind of like that. I think you've got to drink it for what it is, though. And what it is a garden beer. A sit out your garden. Finish is a little bit uncomfortable for some people, I reckon. Or will be. Because it's, the finish on it is a little bit metallic almost. A little bit kind of, bit too dry in a metallic bitter way. It's kind of like there's some hopping done a bit too early, maybe. You know, so, you know, they need to share the hops out a little bit, bring them some of those in that they're putting early, pull some of them back and put them in a bit later, you know. And I think possibly put definitely put quite a few of those hops in later on. You know, almost dry hopping in it. Put them in way late, you know. But that's, it's not supposed to be an American IPA. It's not supposed to be like a fruit bowl. It's very, very nice and very relaxing to drink. There's that bitter little gatecrasher, though. I'm not sure I like him. So yeah, where is he? The prices you buy these for, they're usually around the sort of 150 region and that, you know. So the prices you buy that for, bum 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 bum. Try it, buy it and like it. Let me know, but I think try it, buy it and like it. say to Badgers, though, and I know you've got your recipes and you don't listen to plebs like me, but I would say that some of that early hopping, just get some of it, a few handfuls of it out, and put those in very late, just to kind of perk up the fruitiness a little bit and bring down that metallic-y early hop sort of thing. Just to kind of marry them up a little bit, because they're a little bit imbalanced at the moment, and I would say just have a look at the balance of those. So bring the fruit in a little bit, bring the early stuff away, and you'll have a lovely, lovely, really lovely garden, well, a lovely beer. Not just a garden beer, I reckon, because the Celia will come in as well. Woo. Right, I'll see you in the next one. Take care of yourselves, look after each other. If you see a tramp in a street and things like this, I know, look, I'm not preaching, but if you see a tramp in a street and things like that, don't step over them, you know. Don't sort of, you know, I don't mean to be a preacher and that, but just sometimes just go, how you going, you alright? There's a sandwich. You know, when you're making sandwiches, you're cutting a bit of bread and a bit of butter and a bit of whatever, ham. It's not that costly. Make an extra one. You just go, there you go, mate. It's a sandwich. Got it wrapped up for you. There you go. You know, take care of yourself, mate. I'll see you later. And then say hello to them at the end of the day, and say hello to them tomorrow or something. Maybe even sit down with them or something like that. Sorry, I've gone off the remit, but, you know, be nice. And also, be nice to everyone you meet, because it passes on like a virus. You be nice to the shopkeeper or something, or the till lady at the, you know, supermarket. Hello, sweetheart, hello. Nice to, you know, they go, hello, how are you? And you go, all the better for seeing you. And they're like, oh, really nice. Right, you know, it's just makes it a day. They might go, piss off, or whatever. Just take it, whatever. Okay. And on you go. A lot of the time, it just, like, they'll smile. And the next person comes up, they're like, hello, like this. And they go, oh, hello, and then they pass it on. So, there you go. Anyway, 3D, 3D. This new thing I'm doing now, 3D, 3D. I'm coming to get you. Scary, isn't it? Biddly, biddly, boo. Take care of yourselves. Just scratching me arm there. Take care of yourselves. Bye.